Hey everybody, Tristan and Rory here. Now, it's been 1 year since our battle round on The Voice, and this is a very, very contentious moment, so we're gonna go back right now, we're gonna play it, and we're gonna tell you all the stuff you didn't know.
You said it all, Rory. You said it all.
Hit it, Tris.
Alright, here we go. By the way, this is like what got us trending on Twitter. Oh, there's our parents. It got us trending on Twitter, which was a pretty
worldwide.
Big, worldwide, yeah. And above Aaron Martin.
Oh god, look at the Mickey Mouse arms.
Oh man. We got a lot of comments like if we had worn lingerie, we would have done better, which I don't actually agree with. I think that's true.
That would have been pretty embarrassing.
Now, we should mention that most people on The Voice, in season two at least, their battle partners, they got along.
Cordial relationship. You know? I mean, the thing is with us, it was a little more difficult. You know, we were in such a strange situation. CeeLo had put us together with somebody who was totally different from us. A little nuts. you know... I'm sorry.
Sorry, that was funny.
That was douche.
Oh, wait. This is like... Oh, no, I don't do my guitar move here yet. Yeah, this was such a weird arrangement.
Weird.
See, we came in with a very, very... We actually, the night before, made a demo. Like, a whole demo in Pro Tools and came into the rehearsal, like, with this thing. And it was very, very strange.
And knowing what we kind of wanted to do with it.
Right, here we come. Rory, be quiet. We're going to start singing now. I like that jacket. I wish they had let me keep that jacket.
This one?
No, that's not the same. No, the jacket I'm wearing.
Right. Yep.
Oh, man.
You know, by the way...
Oh, wait, that's my move! That was my move. That got used in the commercials a lot. Blake looks uncomfortable.
Yeah, I was uncomfortable. Now, it was funny. Like, there was a lot of things that were weird. Like, you know... There was like some. She really brought up a lot of questions about like whether we can use guitar or not, and it's like, you know,
and like
do,
a,
man.
Yeah, like one time actually, the music director like during rehearsal. See, like you have rehearsals beforehand that are not filmed, and at one time we were like 20 minutes into rehearsal, and
she was like,
the music,
"More Dirty Diana."
No,
I wanted sexier.
Yeah,
sexy Dirty Diana. Sexy Dirty Diana.
Yeah,
that's what she said.
The music director.
And he was just like, "Oh."
He just walked out. And that was our last rehearsal. So that was an interesting experience.
Yeah.
Sorry, I didn't mean to do Are we going to watch the commentary?
No, that's
good. Should we stop it?
Yeah, I don't need to see the rest of this.
All right, so we don't have to react to their commentary. All right, so I just to summarize, the commentary, Adam and Christina said
that we won.
We should have won.
Blake likes lingerie, so
Blake basically just hit on her, and that was the end. And then, of course, CeeLo chose her over us. And
but that was that. The thing is, though, is the reaction was kind of insane afterwards. It was like thousands of people tweeting about this and screaming at CeeLo about it. And you know,
and
so much to the point that like they like almost inappropriately reacted on their Twitter accounts.
Well, and also in retrospect. Having this experience was probably... If there's a way to get kicked off a reality show amidst
the best, a
big controversy is probably the best way.
Yeah, because if we'd gotten through to the live round and had not gotten through any farther, we would have had nobody talking about us. But this was like a big thing, and there's like people messaging us from South Africa and you know Canada.
Yeah. Actually, that was a really funny thing, too, because this runs and reruns throughout the world.
Yeah, so
like
periodically we'd get...
Every few weeks,
attacking us.
Someone would be like, "Well, you guys got totally screwed." It'd be from like Southeast Asia.
I bet you're bitter. I bet you're stupid. stupid face.
I don't think people say that. Right.
Some people say stuff like that.
Mostly do.
Honestly, I'm just really happy that it was a big deal. You know what I mean? Like that was our main goal going into this thing.
Yeah.
You know, you can't be aiming to win it because there's 300 people and one wins it, and there's like 40,000 people who try out.
Yeah.
It's get what you can out of it. You know what I mean?
We just stole it. We stole the publicity and ran with it
and shake it out of it.
So anyway, so that was that. Thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll talk to you later.
See you later, guys.
Bye.